I'm Stan, and welcome to Science with Stan. As we speak, the balloon is being filled by fart, which you can see from this equation equals to CH4 or methane. And the surrounding air is composed mainly of nitrogen, which you can see from this equation. Now, when the balloon is let go, will the balloon sink or float? Let's see what happens. Now, why does it float? That's because methane is not only lighter than air, but the fart is currently hotter than the surrounding atmosphere. The wonder of science.
Let's go for a ride.
Our situation right now. We've got a car and it's going forward, and we've got Woody the balloon suspended in the middle. The car is about to execute a right turn. Now the question is, which direction would the balloon lean towards? Left or right? As a clue, remember the effect of centrifugal force on the tomato bottle. Now, did most of you choose this direction? Very good! Now let's see what really happens. Aha! As you can see, the balloon does not lean to the left, but instead, seemingly knows which way to lean into a turn. Now why is this? The truth is, something does go to the left, but it's not the balloon. It's the air around it. And because the air is heavier than the balloon, it pushes the balloon back to the right. The wonder of science. Life is full of surprising turns and unexpected roundabouts. I bet sometimes you just feel like the world is just pushing you around. But this is what the Bible has to say. Do not be conformed any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Now, going against the flow of the world is difficult on our own strength, but if we can learn to be like Buni here, and let our hearts be lightened from the cares of this world, and our minds be renewed and transformed by the uplifting word of God, then leaning into the turns that life throws at us can be that much easier. Until next time, Science with Stan.